Shalom, shalom, my beautiful channel family. It's Watchman Adam. I hope everyone's doing well today. I know I am. As always, you're in my prayers. You're such a blessing to me. I love all you guys. Today, we're going to be doing the sixth video in the Olivet Discourse Series. Today, we're going to be looking at the second coming of Jesus, not to be confused with the rapture. So many people look at this verse right here, these verses, and they think, wow, this is pointing towards the rapture when it's not. It's talking about the second coming of Jesus, which is two separate events. You know, the rapture happens, tribulation, and then the second coming at the end of tribulation by Jesus himself, when he will actually touch down on the Mount of Olives. For the first time, he'll touch back down on earth. So today, we're going to be in 24, 27 through 31. And this is what the Word of God says. For as the lightning coming out of the east and shines unto the west, so shall also come the Son of Man be. That's saying lightning. Now, what is lightning? Lightning is swift. It's destructive. It's powerful. The Lord is saying his coming is going to be quick. It's not going to be one of the things where you get to watch him come in slowly, surely. Here he is. He makes it. No. He's coming fast, like lightning. All right? For wheresoever the carcass is, there will be eagles gathered also. All right, I think that means two things. That's saying keep your eyes towards the air, looking at eagles, and where you find sin, sinners are going to be. So in those days, we need to be, the people that are left behind need to be careful. All right, because we're not going to be here at that point. We're gone. 27 through 31, this is in reference to the Jewish nation. This is reference to the Jews, to the ones that have come to the saving power of Jesus and the ones that have it during the tribulation, okay? All right, verse 29 says, immediately after the tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light, and the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of the heavens shall be shaken. Wow. All right, guys, that's a powerful verse right there. All right. It says immediately after the tribulation of those days. So it's saying, like, I mean, let's just take Jesus for what he's saying. He's saying immediately after the tribulation. No pause, immediately after the end of the tribulation. You know, this is the end of Daniel's 7th week right here, all right? Immediately after tribulation of those days shall the sun be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light. That's saying there's going to be darkness, okay? Darkness everywhere. And the stars shall fall from heaven, and the powers of heaven shall be shaken. Wow. That just shows you setting the scene for what's going to happen when the Lord comes down, and he gathers his people up, and he gets ready to set up his millennial reign, right? Verse 30, and then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in the heaven. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn, and they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And then there shall appear the sign. What is the sign? The sign is Jesus himself, of the Son of Man in heaven. He's coming from the heavens. And then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. Who are the tribes? I mean, I think the tribes is saying all the Jewish people of the earth are going to mourn because they're going to see him coming. They're going to recognize, wow, he is Messiah. We put our faith in the Antichrist. You know, and the ones who have come to the saving power of Jesus, it's going to be the best day of their life, man. I mean, this is powerful stuff. And they shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds, in heaven with power and great glory. They're going to physically see it, all right? So they're saying this ain't going to be no secret event. It's going to be visible. And, like, a lot of this he wrote, so I think his disciples were worried that they was going to miss his return, right? And that I think this was Jesus also reassuring them, the generation that sees this return, it's going to see it. It's going to be a visible event. All right, verse 31. A lot of people want to say that this is the rapture. This is not the rapture, and I'm going to hopefully debunk this, all right? And he shall send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet. That sounds like the rapture. It does. And they shall gather together his elect from the four winds from one end of the heaven to the other. All right, let's break this down. Before we do that, I want to go to 1 Thessalonians 4:16. Now, this is the rapture. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. All right, right there it shows you he's coming with the shout of the archangel. All right, right here it says, and he shall send his angels. So it's like he's emptying out heaven is what I'm picturing. He sent it with a great sound of a trumpet. No archangel coming with him, right? It won't make it distinct. And they shall gather together his elect. Who are his elect? These are the people that have come to the saving power, mainly the Jews of Jesus Christ during the tribulation. So they're coming down to earth and they're going to gather his elect from the four winds. That's how we know it's earth. From one end of the heaven to the other. So they're also taking all of us who were raptured. Like, just think about this, man. We're all coming back down, and that's when the Battle of Armageddon happens, all right? All right, the last video in this series is going to be 32 through 51, my favorite part, the parable of the fig tree. Man, it's going to be a really powerful video. I remember when I first read the parable of the fig tree about 10, 12 years ago, and like instantly, like when I read it, the Lord told me, like, wow, this is in reference to Israel. And like, I've always had a love for eschatology and stuff like that. But I'd say probably the past 5 years, it's really grown deeper, man. That's why I love being able to do these videos for you guys. And just know I consider all you like family. I haven't given you something in this video, so I'm going to give it to you real quick. It's the gospel. You always know I have to drop it. It's 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. Who is Jesus? Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He was sent down to earth with one mission, to die and make atonement for our sins, which he did at 33 after starting his earthly ministry at age 30 after living a sinless, perfect life. In 3 years, changed the world forever. Took the most brutal death on the cross ever at age of 33 and laid dead for what? 3 days? 3 days? 3 days? At the end of that third day, he busted that tomb wide open. He ascended to be with the Father. And on this channel, we know he's coming back for us soon. And we are looking for that Titus 2:13 blessed hope, the glorious appearance of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Guys, we see what's going on in the world today. All right, I hope you got something out of this video. Like I said, just remember, Matthew 24 is written to the Jewish people, okay? All the Bible is for Gentile and Jew, but Jesus was talking to Jews of his day, but also, I'm just not going to say Jews, he was also talking to Gentiles, like I said, but when you divide Matthew 24, that's something you really got to remember. So 31 is not the rapture, it's the second coming, okay? Like I said, next verse, we start with the parable of the fig tree. It's going to be the last in this series. I love you guys. I'll be dropping another video tomorrow. If you haven't, please subscribe to the channel. Feel free to share the content. I don't mind. I love you, and I'll see you in my next video. I'm going to close this out with prayer. Father God, thank you for this time together with my channel family. Father God, and you know how much work has been put into this series, Father God. Just let it be a blessing to them or to someone else, Father. And I just want to thank you for what you're doing in our lives. Continue to work in our lives, Father God, and just continue just to be that light that lights our way. Thank you for sending Jesus to die on the cross with us. In your Son, Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Guys, like I said, I'll see you in my next video. And I want to give you all a quick channel recommendation. It's called Breaking It Down with Brenda Lee. B-R-E-N-D-A-L-E-E. Breaking It Down with Brenda Lee. I just subscribed to her channel the past week. You will be blessed by it. Let her know I sent you. I'll see you in my next video. Love you guys.